Assalamualaikum and welcome to another episode of Zealfit TV. Today we are going to continue our barbell series, and in this particular episode we're going to talk about the Eleiko IPF competition bar. So much have been said about this IPF powerlifting competition bar on other YouTube channels. I really don't know what else I can add to the discussion. But let me just start off by mentioning a few key points about the bar. Number one, it's 29 mm in grip diameter. So that's similar to the performance powerlifting bar and also the rack bar. And because of the diameter, according to Eleiko, it makes the bar stiffer, right? But I want to say that it makes it a lot stiffer. I still have a problem wrapping my head around the fact that a 1 mm difference in the grip diameter makes a whole lot difference in terms of the stiffness. And I can tell you that this bar is really stiff. I've seen powerlifters in my showroom here who actually moved from a regular bar, a regular 28 mm bar, into a 29 mm bar, specifically the performance powerlifting bar. And the feedback that I got was that it's really stiff. It's very difficult to, especially when you're deadlifting, it's very difficult for you to move it off the floor. Okay, so I remember that when I started out this business, a lot of people still don't know about the Eleiko competition bar or the performance powerlifting bar. They assume that it's just like another bar, but whenever they use it for deadlift or squats, they can feel the difference in terms of how difficult it is to deadlift and I would guess squat as well. That's because it doesn't give you any slack at all when you pull the bar up. So that's one big difference in terms of a 29 mm bar and a 28 mm bar.
What I want to demonstrate now is to see how stiff this bar is. So I'm going to load the bar and see when it actually bends. Are you able to see it yet? That's, I don't know how much is that, 170 kilos? That's 220. That's a slight flexing of the bar. Let's just load another 50 kgs. I hope that this squat stand can withstand the weight. All right, that's, what's that, 270? Yeah, can you see the bend? I'm not too sure whether, I think the video is a bit off, it's not level. But from my point of view, now it has a slight bend. Okay, what I'm going to try to do now is to take the XF bar, which is a 28 mm bar, and I'm going to load up as much as what's on the IPF competition bar, and just let's see the difference in terms of when the 28 mm bar actually bends. What we have right here now is the XF bar, 20 kg. We're gonna load it up with the IPF competition plates and see at which point that it actually bends. Yeah, from my point of view, that is that slight flexing of the bar, even at 170 kgs. Let's just put another 50 kg. Can you guys see it? It's already bent towards the end. Let's just go on and put in another 50 kg, like just like we did with the IPF bar. Yeah. Way more noticeable bending of the bar at 270 kgs. That's why it's important to know the type of bar that you're getting, okay? If you're somebody who likes to pull the slack off on a deadlift, right? So definitely the IPF competition, even the performance powerlifting bar, it's probably not meant for you. But if you are an IPF powerlifter, then you have to use this bar because that's what being used in all the IPF competitions. And you need to be able to get used to it because if you are training with a different bar, it might not translate into the weights that you're going to lift during your meet. So, very important point. Secondly, is the graphite bushings that it uses. Now, according to Eleiko, that makes this bar able to handle heavy loads, and it's supposed to be durable as well. The last and most significant difference about this competition bar as opposed to other Eleiko bars is that this is raw steel. It's not coated at all. What that means is that eventually it will rust and there's no escaping it as far as I know. Those who have owned this bar accept the fact that this bar will rust eventually, okay? However, because it's not coated or it's not chromed, the knurling is more aggressive. When you apply a coat on the bar, you are essentially covering up the edges of the knurl, right? So without that coat, the knurl is like in its original form. So it's very, very sharp. And it's noticeable even when I'm just, you know, doing this. I have the performance powerlifting bar, the older version, which is in, I think it was 2018. And I have another one, which is a 2020 version. And the 2018 version is slightly more aggressive. But this, to my touch, is even more aggressive than that one. Okay, so obviously, if you put weights on this and you start deadlifting on it, you will definitely feel the aggressiveness, the sharpness of the knurling. So those are the three things that you might want to look out for when you get this bar. The question I usually get from customers is that whether or not they should get this competition bar. Generally speaking, whenever anyone wants a competition bar, and if he's a consumer and not a business, I would recommend that they stay away from the competition bars. That includes the weightlifting and as well as the competition, the powerlifting competition bar. The reason is that in all likelihood, that's not something that they need unless they are a competitive IPF powerlifter. Why? Because each federation uses its own bar. Right, they might use a similar bar, but sometimes they, like for example, some federations might use a specific deadlift bar, which is 27 mm, which is very whippy, right? I have a rogue deadlift bar in the showroom, and number one, the bar is long and the grip is 27 mm, and it's very, very whippy, and it gives a different feeling when you lift with the bar. You need to know whether or not the federation that you're competing in is using a 29 mm bar, specifically if they're using an Eleiko IPF competition bar. So if that's the case, then I would recommend that you get this bar because you want to have as close as possible to the competition setting that you can. Now, you'll probably think about the rust. That's inescapable. If you do not like your bar to rust, then you go for the performance powerlifting bar.
It is essentially identical, except for the coating. However, this bar comes with a lifetime warranty, not against wear and tear, but against any manufacturing defects. And of course, you get this lovely sticker right here, which differentiates between the competition and also the performance powerlifting bar. However, if you are a powerlifting gym, then I would recommend at least getting one of this bar so that you can have a mock meet. People can just train with the competition bar to prepare for the actual event itself. Otherwise, I do not recommend this bar for anybody. You know, I mean, it's a bit overkill. And especially if you are commercial gyms, this is not a bar that you should be getting. You are better off either getting the rack bar or the performance powerlifting bar. Assuming that you are a competitive powerlifter in IPF, but you do not have the budget for the competition bar, what should you get? Then my recommendation would be to get the performance powerlifting bar. If that's not enough, then you go for the rack bar. But please note that the rack bar doesn't have the knurling where the J cup meets the bar. So it doesn't have a knurling right here. It doesn't have any knurling right there. I don't know how wide your bench grip would be, but if your grip is that wide, then the rack bar is not suitable for you. Then you just get the performance powerlifting bar. So in conclusion, who is this bar meant for? It's probably meant for a competitive IPF powerlifter. And obviously, if you are an organizer of an IPF event, you probably need to get this bar as well. Oh, there's a reason why I bought this bar for the showroom. Number one is to make this video. Number two is to have it on showcase so that people can touch and feel the bar and try it out. Number three is I want to see the rate of rust. So this is probably just part one of the IPF competition bar. There will be a part two where I'll probably talk about how fast this bar rusts. I'm sure you know that I'm in Malaysia. Malaysia is a tropical country, so the weather here is hot and humid. Our seasons are either it's too hot or it's rainy. I'm here in the showroom. This place is not air-conditioned. Most of the time, it's not air-conditioned. I've already shut down the gym portion of it, so it's just purely for showroom. So we'll just leave the bar right behind me, and then we'll see how fast the rust comes up. Today is 28th of April 2021, so I will see you guys again with this bar when I make the second part of the video. Until then, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel, please subscribe to it. And don't forget to turn on the notification button so that you are informed whenever we post a new video. If you have any comments or questions about this IPF competition bar, do leave your comments and questions in the comment section below. If you need to get in touch with me, my email is in the description. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you again, inshallah, in the next Zealfit TV episode. Bye.